I didn't plug in my computer. Head over heels. I hope you dig some of these 80s jams. I'll do some standards too. Check it out. I wanted to be with you alone and talk about the weather, but traditions I can't trace against a child in your face won't escape my attention. You keep your distance with a system of touch and gentle persuasion. I'm lost in admiration. Could I need you this much? Oh, oh, you're just wasting. Oh, you're just wasting time. Happens and I'm head over heels. I never find out till I'm head over heels. Something happens and I'm head over heels. Oh, don't take my heart, don't break my heart, don't throw it away. I'm going cold turkey on this one. I just wanted to sing it like it was in my head, you know what I mean? Throw it away. I'm made of fire and watching it burn. Thought of your future with one foot in the past. Now just how long will it last? No, 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 you have no ambition. My mother and my brothers used to breathe in clean air and dreaming I'm a doctor. It's hard to be a man when there's a gun in your hand. Oh, I'm feeling so. Something happens and I'm head over heels. I never find out till I'm head over heels. Ooh. Head over heels. Oh, don't take my heart, don't break my heart, don't throw it away. What's happening, Annette Limon? How you doing? Good afternoon. I'm playing with Head Over Heels, Tears for Fears. It's something I just wanted to do on the fly. I do a lot of songs just right off the cuff. La 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 la. La 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 la. In my mind's eye, one little boy wandering by. I'm on the line, open my mind. This is my four-leaf clover. There it is. Tears for Fears. I'm gonna let it play a little bit more. I really dig this jam, you know what I mean? I like playing around with tunes that I've never rehearsed it. There's some cool parts I'm messing with here. Let's try it again. But anyways, I was gonna go live closer to 4 o'clock, and then seconds before I was gonna click live, everything turned off. But here we go. I wanted to be with you alone and talk about the weather, but traditions I can't trace against a won't escape my attention. You keep your distance with a and gentle persuasion. I'm lost in admiration. Could I? Oh, oh. you're wasting my time. Something happens and I'm head over heels. Okay, I'm trying to figure that one out, but I dig this jam. It's from my high school days, the 80s. Don't throw it away. All right. Throw it away. I'm made of burn. A thought of your future with one foot in the past, not just how. No. Have you no ambition? That's the line. My mother and my brothers used to. And dreaming I'm a doctor. Alright, let me pause this music. We already went through Head Over Heels, Tears for Fears. I'm gonna put a little pause on that. And so last week I did a presentation. Not a presentation. I facilitated a discussion in a theory class that I was doing, and we read Américo Paredes with his pistol in his hand about Gregorio Cortez. Part of my facilitation / semi-presentation, I sang, and look at, you know, just like how this show was going to start, everything was smooth, and then, like I said, all the power came off, so then I had to replug everything, and, you know, so I started around 4:12, but just like my presentation on Tuesday evening, I was going to sing the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez, and then I thought I should try and figure out a little guitar part. Then I thought, okay, I kind of have a decent little guitar going, and I was singing along fairly well with it. And like 20 minutes before the class started, one of the strings broke on my guitar. And so I was like, damn. But, you know, I love the acoustic. And thankfully, I have an electric guitar that also is a hollow body. So it can do some acoustic kind of stuff. And I plugged it in and it worked for me. But it was when you feel the difference of the strings or get used to things, you know, that's what happens. You know, I may do, thankfully, with the tools I had. And but I'm going to sing for you right now the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez. This was written in 1901. And the history of it is that Gregorio Cortez and his brother Ramon were from Mexico, south of the border, in the lower Rio Grande area of Texas, right? And they came north because they heard of good working opportunities, and eventually, had a farm that they were working on with this American landowner. And there was troubles along the border, tensions with the U.S. Rangers that were very violent and aggressive with the Mexican residents. There was lots of tension with the native indigenous, the native North American Indian communities as well. So there was a lot going on, but the biggest violation, I think, was the way that the Rangers were murdering lots of Mexican, because they would accuse them of being horse thieves. And so the sheriff goes to visit Gregorio Cortez, and there's a translation that is a loss in translation about the difference between selling a horse and a mare. And other translations were messed up too, of just a simple thing of someone in English saying to Gregorio's brother that they want you, meaning they want to see you, they want to talk to you. The translation comes across as you're a wanted man, right? So when you see somebody with a badge and you're kind of like, what's going on? The other confusion was that when they asked Gregorio Cortez or his brother, did you sell a horse? And they said no, because there's a different word instead of caballo. I don't have that word with me,
But for a mare, it's a different word in Spanish. So the sheriff was gonna arrest Gregorio Cortez. One of the poor habits of the Rangers back then was that they would shoot first and ask questions later. And in this case, the sheriff drew his gun and was walking towards Gregorio when his brother ran towards the sheriff. The sheriff shot him in the mouth. And as he fell, the sheriff then took three shots at Gregorio Cortez and missed. And Gregorio Cortez was armed and shot back, and he didn't miss. He ended up killing the sheriff. So the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez leans a lot on the folklore and the tensions of Mexicans along the border at the turn of the century. And in 1901, many variations of the story and Ballad of Gregorio Cortez were made. I'm going to do a unique version because I'm not exactly playing a corrido in the instrumentation, but kind of. In the country. Let me give it a shot. I may mess up, but here we go. Here is 1901, the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez. In the country. All right. In the country of El Carmen, a great misfortune befell. The sheriff is dead. Who killed him, no one can tell. At 2 in the afternoon, in half an hour or less, they knew the man who killed him had been Gregorio Cortez. They let loose the bloodhounds. They followed him from afar. But trying to catch Cortez was like following a star. All the rangers of the country were flying. They rode so hard. What they wanted was to get the $1,000 reward. In the country of Kansas. In the country of Kansas, they cornered him after all. Though they were no more than 300, they leaped. He leaped out of their corral. Then the major sheriff said, as if he was going to cry, Cortez, hand over your weapons. We want to take you alive. Then said Gregorio Cortez, as his voice was like a bell, you will never get my weapons till you take me in a cell. Then said Gregorio Cortez, with his pistol in his hand, and so many mounted rangers, just to take one Mexican. Then said Gregorio Cortez, with his pistol in his hand, ah, so many mounted rangers, just to take one Mexican. Well, I hope you enjoyed the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez. I know, you know, identity is such a funny thing. We're in Hispanic Heritage Month. Lots of people don't like to be considered Hispanic. Just like Dolores Huerta, I understand, a few days ago, was asked about the identity of Latinx. And she said that she didn't care for the term. I guess it, you know, doesn't resonate, doesn't identify with so many of us. And I'm in that, I guess you could say, thought process as well. I think that there is a place for Latinx, Chicanx, for parts of the younger generation and how they can claim their own identity, which I'm totally in support of. But I don't like the usage of the term that goes back in history and might call the Chicano movement the Chicanx movement, or they might call Chicana feminist movement the Chicanx feminist movement. I think that there is a lot of erasure that happens when we use the term anachronistically, meaning out of history. Like it's not the way people define their, they didn't recognize themselves as Chicanx back then, so we shouldn't call them that. But like I said, you know, identity is one of those issues that also comes to mind because of all the classes I'm taking. And I'm thinking about you know, how we talk about history and learn about different figures. And this was such a cool class that this is a cool class that I'm in, and I'm happy I could share that with you. All right, you know what I'm gonna do is, before I lose my train of thought and ramble. Let's see. There's another song that I pulled out. But speaking of Hispanic Heritage Month, even though I don't agree with the name, I figured it would be cool to share some history. You know, and one more thing I would say, you know, aside from identity, just the history of Mexican nationals, Chicanos, Chicanx, is that the relevance of the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez and our community, our cultural memory and our people, ever since, you know, that invasion of Mexico, the loss of all the land, it's just, you know, there's always been this tension, this devaluing of the humanity of people of Mexican descent, or mixture, mestizaje, meaning your mixture of the Spanish that came across, you know, in 1519 on, through, you know, colonizing Mexico up to 1821, 1519 to 1821. So lots of mixture between indigenous, the Spanish, and so it is a mestizaje. But nevertheless, whoever you are, if you have brown skin and if you're in a particular place, you're looked at as a foreigner, the constant foreigner, or a threat to America, you know. And you could see these tensions with the law at times acting completely lawless and violent. I was looking at it as a history of these are early ideas of American terror. You know, we talk about terror all the time and police abuse and murders even to this day. So there's tons of relevance here. 1901 with Gregorio Cortez. And if you go 50 years earlier in the 1850s, and you had Joaquin Murrieta, who, you know, is another, you know, social bandit hero who was, with Joaquin Murrieta, he was a vaquero. He had a gold dig site. He was digging for gold here in California, but the Anglos came and pushed him off. And they ended up, they weren't the police, but it was the society, the community. They ended up lynching his brother and raping his wife. And so Joaquin Murrieta, you know, went on a revenge run, and he got revenge. And then, but then he goes on the run because now he can't stay here, you know. Anyhow, you know what? We're going to switch up with all that stuff. Let's see. Da, 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 da. I got that song in my head now. In the country of El Carmen, a great misfortune befell. Yeah, Anna, that's some crazy stuff, right? I see little emojis. Joaquin Murrieta, 1850s. It's a hard history. Gregorio Cortez, 1901. You know. George Floyd, 2020. And everybody in between. It's a heavy history. But hey, I am going to switch it up now to another song that has been on my mind actually for a couple of months, and I just thought about maybe I should sing it too. So we just did Head Over Heels, one of my favorite songs when I was in high school. And this is another song from my childhood. I mean, I was super young, but I was in the 70s. That was my total childhood years, 1972. Let's see. Let me click some buttons here and let's do this. Here's 1972, Todd Rundgren. Hello, it's me. Here we go. Hello, it's me. I thought about us for a long, long time. Maybe I think too much, but something's wrong. There's something here that doesn't last too long. Maybe I shouldn't think of you as mine. Seeing you or seeing anything as much as I can do, I take for granted that you're always there. I take for granted that you just don't care. Sometimes I can't help seeing all the way through. Oh, it's important to me that you know you are free. 'Cause I never want to make you change for me. Think of me. You know that I'd be with you if I could. I'll come around to see you once in a while. Or if I ever need a reason to smile and spend the night if you think I should. Oh, no. Free, 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 yeah, 'cause I never want to make you change for me. Oh, think of me. You know I wanted to be with you if I could. I'll come around and see you once in a while. Or if I ever need a reason to smile and spend the night if you think I should. Oh, oh. Think of me.
Think of me. Think of me. Think of me.
Yeah. Think of me. A little bit of Todd Rundgren. Well, that was the first. You got to hear it for the first time with me. I hope you enjoyed it. Lots of songs. I love just going straight on it. I guess I don't know if it's a good habit or a bad habit, but I like playing with stuff that I don't rehearse with, just to see where I'm at, you know? Okay. Yes, I like playing with songs. It's just kind of like, what do I remember about it? And maybe I'll make up a different phrasing to a line within the inspiration of the, you know, the original tune and the melody. Here's another one. Last week I did it for the first time. Let's see if I can find it. And, look at this. It's a watermelon with I was going to say, not oregano, not basil, mint? I can't remember. But Martha made some really great, some fresh watermelon juice. Squeeze some lemons in there. I got a show next Saturday with Tierra in Peoria, Arizona. Tower of Power and Tierra. I don't know who else is on the bill, but I'm going to get up and sing two songs, maybe three. I don't know. But that'll be fun. I'm going to, I didn't have the option to fly, but I think it, for me, I'm still, you know, it's like, you know, to do as best as you can in isolation, you know, I'm going to drive by myself, and it's a 5-hour drive. I think I'm going to figure out what the technology, how it can work for me so that the readings that I'm doing, I can get them on audio, so I need to figure that out, so I can listen to them, because 10 hours is a huge chunk of time, and probably stop and grab something to eat, blah, 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 so probably about 6 hours, it's about 12-hour chunk, that's huge, trying to do all this schoolwork and stay up to date with everybody, so that's going to be my challenge next weekend. It's going to be a mixture of fun and work and all that. But let's get back. Let's see. Looks like we got some people here, though. Let me give a shout out to my friend Anna Palma, one of my sponsors, by the way, here on HAPS, along with Betty Parra. Incredible sponsorship from Betty Parra as well, and Ana Davalos. And I'm asking you, my friends that love the songs that I do in our chat, and you know, I go off subject and talk about other things, like our history. but come on over to HAPS. Get the app. Make a free profile. And there's like, if you, you know, you can support me as an independent artist. And there's like a coin system. And you can leave like little tips. And a sponsorship option. You know, you can, any amount that you would like, and it supports what I do as an artist, singer, songwriter, artist. I would appreciate it, of course. I shared my links as well. I have Venmo, Cash App, and PayPal at the top of the chat. And I do see there's about 20 of us on, and some of you are probably streaming, catching the live stream from Facebook. And I think Facebook might have made adjustments. I'm not sure because I looked last week and I think I'm seeing the chats from all the different pages, but I wouldn't rely on it too much. So if you're out there on Facebook and you're commenting and saying hi or hey, what's up, and I'm not replying to you, it's because I don't see your comments. But try and go to my Gregorio Esparza music page. And from there, if you catch the live stream, and comment, I believe I will see your comments. Other than that, you know, I can give you shout outs and I recognize you and see you. I am encouraging everybody, if you like what I do, come on over to HAPS and get in the chat over here and support what I do. Last week, I did for the first time a Paul Davis song from 1981. Whoops. Let me get back to the songs here. And I'm just going to go easy on it. I know there's a modulation somewhere towards the end, but I'll sing some of it, talk over some of it. I'm trying not to oversing today. Yeah, just want to relax. And anything you guys want to talk about, ask me some questions. Tell me where you're at. How is your day? What city are you in? And let's get a chat going, too. But open forum, you know. If you have questions about music or anything you want to ask me, hit me up, hit me up, hit me up. Okay, here's Paul Davis, 1981, with Cool Night. I sometimes wonder why all the flowers had to die. I dream about you and I. Summer's come and gone, and the nights they seem so long. Come on over tonight. Come on over, it's gonna be a cool night. Just let me hold you by the firelight. If I don't feel right, you can go. Oh, on a cool night, brings back memories of a good life when this love was not so old. I won't talk about the past, how love's supposed to last forever, and you don't have to take a stand. Lay out all your plans. Come on over tonight. Come on over, it's gonna be a cool night. Hold you by the firelight. If it don't feel right, you can go. Cool night brings back memories of a good life when this love's not so old. Booster Club for the Rams. All right. Looks like that's happening out in Fullerton, City of Orange. Then it's back home to the City of Orange. Nice. Sounds like fun. But tonight, come on over. Cool night, let me hold you by the firelight. If I don't feel right, you can go. Cool night, let me hold you by the firelight. If it don't feel right, you can go. Let me hold you. If it don't feel right, you can't go. Cool night, let me hold you. By the firelight, you can't go. That's Cool Night by none other than Mr. Paul Davis, 1981. There it is. All right. So how's that fundraiser going out there in Fullerton? What's happening, Anna? It's good to hear that. Sounds like a lot of fun. Whoa. All right. Let's see. I might have to come back to Hello, It's Me again. Just like last week when I did that CCR jam. Did it a couple times and then I had to close out with it. You know what I mean? You know what I'll play with real quick? I haven't done it in a while. One of my favorite standards. I know I've definitely been bending the genres through the last quite a few weeks now. Sorry, I can't get my thought out. But and there was a time where I was purely doing standards at 4 o'clock. And okay, so we're gonna. I want to do a standard or two or three, maybe a little bit more rock. And then I'll probably end this. I'm definitely aiming to end this stream much sooner. I've been going closer to 2 hours pretty steady now as well. And, you know, with the work that I'm doing, I'm feeling the pressure of like having to get to it. You know what I mean? But we're going to move on over to that Bob Stewart arrangement that I like. That some of you know, I love singing this on a clear day. And here's an American standard for you. 1965, on a clear day. You can see forever. Nice change up, you know what I mean? Clear day, rise and look around you, and you see whom you are. On a clear day, how it will astound you that the glow of your being outshines every star. You feel part of every mountain, sea, and shore. You can hear from far and near a world you've never heard before. And on a clear day, on that clear day, you can see forever and ever and evermore. All right. Yeah. Oh, I love that. Love that piano, you know what I mean? You feel part of every mountain, sea, and shore. You can hear from far and near a world you never heard before. And on that clear day, on that clear day, you can see forever and ever and ever and ever. Wow, that was a funky note. Oh man, you know what happens. Evermore. But I think I was singing flat to the music on the ever part. I was thinking, oh, what do I do here? I want to do something different. But it's still kind of funky cool. And let's see. All right. Let me pull this stack over here of some of the standards I got. Let's see, just to bring the Rams fans together to have fun watching the game together with raffles, food, drinks. That's right. I remember after that show that I did in July, you guys, you and your family were heading to something later that day, and you'd invited me to come on down. But it's been on pause for almost 2 years, right, because of COVID. And, you know, the COVID thing. You know, Martha said something smart the other day. You know, I'm more cynical, but we're both very cautious, you know, about just the way things are unfolding. Obviously, COVID is COVID, dangerous as all hell. But she said, you know, people are just getting used to living with it now. And because, man, you know, maybe there was a Dodger game yesterday, but I'm out here in Echo Park by, you know, Dodger Stadium. And so it was just packed, like people coming into the Echo Park area. And, but it was definitely a game, had to be. And I'm just like, I commented, I just said, wow, it just seems like people just don't care anymore. But, you know, she's right. I mean, with time, I mean, the idea is we're learning how to live with it. And like, so I mentioned, you know, doing my second major public performance since March 2020, right? I did the July 10th, I think it was, at the swap meet. It was the first time I did a major public thing. And if you notice, I mean, lots of artists for every week for months have been doing shows. And, you know, that's a 50-50. It's a personal choice, right? Speaking of personal choices, I think of Texas now. But, you know, and I made the choice to abstain from being overly active with major shows in public. So I'll probably in time, you know, do more and more, but also balance between the schoolwork that I'm doing. So I won't be doing as much, obviously, as everybody else, but still, you know, I just, as the opportunities come, I'll figure it out and just try and be as safe as I can, you know? Yeah. Social anxiety, you know, in crowds is a real thing now, you know? I think what's tricky is that, you know, we're seeing friends in public spaces that we haven't seen from the communities that we're in, like as in the music community. And half of us might have masks and some of us don't. And people are like in each other's faces. Like, that was one thing that tripped me out from the last public event I did, is that the music was so loud, meaning not just in my performance, but like after I sang and being around people, that you had to be in each other's faces, like to hear each other speak, which I didn't particularly like or enjoy. And so I stuck around and, you know, it was a trip. It was a trip. Great event. I mean, happy for people. I think people were extra, I guess you could say, sauced, you know what I'm saying? Because like it was just a, you know, loud music and live music and alcohol. And so it's kind of, you get a whole mixture of people and all their different, what they're coming with, you know what I mean, to the table and bringing to the party, literally, you know, and what kind of attitudes, you don't know because you haven't seen people. Do they believe in vaccines or not? Are they holding out? Have they been vaccinated? The whole nine yards, you know, we can hear this story 24/7 every day now. So, but you know what I'm talking about. What are you saying? Yes, it is taking me by surprise because I don't want anyone that close to me. Right. I mean, it is a real thing to still be out. And I did a parade thing. Remember, that was a non-sanctioned, kind of like a public thing, but there was a lot of space. And that was different too, you know, less people. And it's just amazing. You know, we had mass and everybody did what they could to, you know, be safe. And I guess that's the best we can do at this point. But hey, Nena, good to see you. And you're sitting here with Steve and Mary. Tell them I'm saying hello to you too. It's so good to hear from you. By the way, Steve, I have been wanting to get in touch with you since I was trying to call you. I mean, you're a busy guy and, you know, everybody's got things going on. It was before the 50th anniversary of the Chicano moratorium last year. I ended up going to it and walking and meeting with people and singing for people in private, you know, in little after gatherings, some political songs that I wrote because of George Floyd, you know, everything happening last year. Wow. But anyways, I've been, you know, you and Mary are always on our minds, Steve, Mary. So hello. Oh my goodness. It's so good to hear from you. And it seems like forever. I'm so happy to hear from you. Let me see. I'm going to look at another tune. I hope the music is coming through okay for you, because That's one thing with Haps. The quality in the recordings after, we talked about this a couple months back, is not like, I don't know if you hear all the bottom and the mid sounds. I hear it great in my headphones. So that kind of bums me out. I want you guys to get this deep, rich musical experience, you know, with your headphones on. But hopefully if you're listening in, you're listening to me on a surround sound system from your televisions or something like that. I'm going to do a Tony Bennett song for you. Let's see. Let me see if I can cue it up real quick. And we'll get on with Mr. Tony Bennett. Here we go. All right. It seems like dreams, like I've always had, could be, should be, making me glad. Why am I blue? It's up to you to explain. I'm thinking maybe, baby, I'll go away. Someday, some way, maybe you'll come and say, it's you that I need. Oh, and you'll be pleading in vain. It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue. And even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be me. No, no, no. Might never be cross or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do. For nobody else gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still. It had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you. Oh, yes. I hope you love my piano man right there. Had to be you. There's some nice standards. What other standards you think you want to hear? I mean, I haven't done the standards in a while. I got the Days of Wine and Roses, which you know I love. Ooh, The Good Life. Autumn Leaves. Mamselle. Ooh, Mamselle. Moon River. I got them all. Strangers in the Night, Best is Yet to Come, I've Got You Under My Skin. Maybe we could play with Sinatra. But yes, Steve says call anytime. You know what, Steve? I definitely will. I will. And I've been seeing the flyers you've been putting out. I think November 6th, a great event for a great cause. Raise money for a scholarship under your brother's name. So Steve Salas, Tierra family, friends, former members of Tierra, and other special guests and appearances. November 6th at ELAC, and raising money for a scholarship in the name of Rudy Salas. I think it's going to be a beautiful event. It looks incredible. And, give me a call. Give me a call if you want me to come on by and sing one with you, man. Let me know. I'll give you a call, though. It would be great. Last night, Martha and I were here with one of her, one of her peers, Professor Elias Serna, and we were here, you know, theorizing, philosophizing, talking about history, and we had some space, you know, add a couple more people to the room. So if you ever want to hang, Bunny has an incredible library, and so we've built what you would think of as a salon library. So the space is just conducive, man, to thinking, contemplating, complicating. It's music, it's poetry, it's information. It's really a cool space, beautiful space that we have. And it would be nice, man, to come on down. You know, change the pace and hang with us for an evening. I know it's getting crazy. Martha's teaching at UC Davis. And at the community college here, but UC Davis quarter system is gonna start up in a matter of days. And by the way, Steve, I went back to school. Well, you know, I've been back in school, but I'm over at Cal State LA now in a master's program, man. And I'm just, you know, it's like that one commercial. I'm like a sponge. I'm there, you know, front row, man, just getting all the information. But anyways, since I'm in this, I got back onto this little standards flow. But thank you, Nena, for being here. And Steve and Mary, we love you guys. We love you guys. Estelle, my prima, how are you? Good to see you as well. Doing a mixture of 70s pop, did some Todd Rundgren, Paul Davis, and I did some Tony Bennett. I'm going to do a Sinatra tune right now. Go back to, let me cue it up. Let's see. The best is yet to come, Mr. Frank Sinatra. Here it is. Check out the big band. Count Basie arrangement, 1959. Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day o' mine, come the day o' mine, I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine, we're gonna run that cup dry. Wait till your charms are ripe for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but baby, you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day you're mine, and you're gonna be mine. Yes, you're gonna be mine. Come the day you're mine. Oh yeah, little Sinatra. Wanna go back to some Tony Bennett, or maybe I do some more pop, some more rock and roll. Could do some. Did some Billy Idol last week. I did some Credence. We did Credence, right? Some John Lennon, Watching the Wheels.
Ooh.
Norwegian Wood. Ah, la, la. Okay, this song I can't get out of my head. I'm going to do, let's see. There's Days of Wine and Roses. Farm Leaves. Give me a sec here. Because I kind of feel like doing Shadow of Your Smile. Beautiful, beautiful tune. Night and Day, of course. Cole Porter. But Send in the Clowns, so I don't want to make you cry. Remember I told you I was afraid to do that song? Gonna make me cry. Gonna make me cry. Luck be a lady, Little River. Well, I don't know if I got it near. I had it. Let me do a little fanning through. Quiet Nights and Quiet Stars. I haven't done that one in a while. You know I love that one. Here it is. Maybe I'll do Quiet Night and Quiet Stars. Then we'll go back to some rock and roll. Quiet nights and quiet stars. Quiet chords from my guitar. Floating on the silence that surrounds us. Ooh, there it is. Okay. Let's see. Let's see. So what's up, everybody? What is up? What is up? A big shout out. Mary and Steve Salas over there with Nena Cervantes Carduno, our good friends. Love to y'all. Anna Palma giving you another shout out. My prima Estelle. And Betty Parra is here. I think she's still with us here. Maybe we're in the background, but Betty and Anna always here every week. Nena, you know, quite often we see you. So good to see you. And at the top of the chat stream, I saw Annette Limon. So hopefully you're still with me here. 57 minutes into my session. And I know it's like I'm thinking, I'm just going to do 30 minutes. I'm just going to do an hour. And I have a feeling we're going to keep going for a little bit longer. But let's do The Shadow of Your Smile. 1965. I'm going to find that. Let me see. The. Is it under the? I always do this. Shadow. Is it under SH or the? There it is. Here we go, everybody. One day we walked along the sand. One day in early spring, you held a piper in your hand to mend its broken wing. Now I'll remember many a day and many a lonely mile. The echo of the piper's song, the shadow of a smile. The shadow of your smile when you are gone. will color all my dreams and light the dawn. Look into my eyes, my love, and see all the lovely things you are to me. I wish for a little star was fine to teardrop kissed your lips, and so did I. Can bring, I will be remembering the shadow of your smile, shadow of your smile. Yeah, yeah. There it is. Shadow of your smile. Oh, I wish I could see the other streams. I know there's other people that are probably like saying, yo, what's up, what's up, what's up? But people, I'm telling you, if you're catching me, when I'm on Haps, people are catching me from across the social media, from Facebook to YouTube, Twitter, Twitch, Instagram. So if you're out there, if you're commenting, I can't see your comments unless you do two things. One, you could jump on over to Gregorio Esparza Music, my Facebook page there. Most likely I'll catch your comments. But also I'm asking my friends to come on over to Haps. It's where I'm broadcasting out of right now. And for Haps, it's H-A-P-P-S. Get the app, create a free profile, and hopefully you'll continue supporting me or enjoying the music that I like to sing to. And you can leave me tips, but I also, you know, I provide my Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, but you can leave me tips or become a sponsor. And that's what I'm doing, is I'm building my soul family of people that believe in me and what I do. And hopefully you join as a sponsor. And so each month, you know, the amount of a coffee or more, whatever amount that you feel that you want to send my way and support, you can become a sponsor, and it'll be a monthly thing for as long as you want, right? But I got more to share, of course. You know, my CD is back out. It's streaming live across Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, YouTube Music. My whole album is also on Snapchat, Instagram, and TikTok. So I'm asking all my friends, stream my music, download my music, play with my music on those social media platforms. And we'll talk more about that after I do this next little tune, this next little one. Let's see. Let me get on over. It's going to be a John Lennon tune. La la da di da, la 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 la, la 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 la. It is.
I once had a girl, or should I say, she once had me. She showed me her room. Isn't it good? Norwegian wood. She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere. So I looked around and I noticed there wasn't a chair. I sat on a rug, biding my time, drinking her wine. We talked until two, then she said, it's time for bed. La da dee da, la 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 la. La 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 la, la la da dee da, la 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 la, la 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 la. She told me she worked in the morning and started to laugh. I told her I didn't and crawled up to sleep in the bath. Oh, oh, and when I awoke, this bird had flown, this bird had flown. Whoops. So I lit a fire. Isn't it good? Norwegian wine. La la da di da, da na na na, da na na na.
Nice melody. Now that I got that one stuck in your head, it's going to be there for a week at least. What was the other one I did? Remember last week for the first time? Let me find the lyrics. This one's Lennon Yoko Ono. Lennon Ono. Let me get on over to it. Recently added tunes. Da, 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 da. There it is. I don't know if I'll do it justice because we're still going practically cold turkey on this one. 1974 from the Walls and Bridges album. Here comes number 9, Dream. Thank you, Anna. Here we go. This has been stuck in my head all week, by the way, since last Sunday. So long ago, was it in a dream? Was it just a dream? I know, yes I know. Seems so very real. It seems so very real to me. Took a walk down the street. Through the heat whispered trees. Here. Somebody call out my name as it started to rain. Two spirits dancing strange. Baba Wakawa, who said to say? Baba Wakawa, who said to say? Baba Wakawa, who said to say? Dream, dream away. Magic in the air. Was it magic in the air?
believe, yes, I believe. More I cannot say. What more can I say? On a river of sound, through the merry-go-round, round, you. I thought I could feel you. Feel music touching my soul. Something warm, sudden cold. The spirit dance was unfolding, yeah. I was down, I was shaking, shaking. Oh yeah, John Lennon, Yoko, number 9, Dream, one more time. Come on, let's take it out now. Check out the motels. I'm gonna play around with it. You know, I'm not singing this one all the way. It happened one summer. It happened one time. It happened forever. And for a short time. A place for a moment. An end to a dream. Forever I love. Forever it seems. One summer never ends. One summer never begins. It keeps me standing still. It takes all of my will. And then suddenly, last summer, suddenly one summer never ends. One summer never begins. It keeps me standing still. And then suddenly, suddenly, last summer, then suddenly, last summer. I'm gonna do that other Motels jam right now. That's a 1983 cut. Beautiful, beautiful music. Always inspired me as a kid when I'd hear this music, you know? It's funny, I mean, I like the 80s better now than I did when I was a kid, but there was stuff I liked, you know? I grew up oldies but goodies, you know, standards and all that. So I was always a few decades off from my contemporary, my peers, loving my music, but loving the older stuff better. And now I can look back at the 80s and truly appreciate songs that touched me, you know what I'm saying? As a young kid, the sounds I can love them and appreciate them much more.
Last summer, and then suddenly,
all right. The All For One album by The Motels, 1982. Here's Only the Lonely.
That other, Suddenly Last Summer, is from another album I'll tell you about in a second.
We walked lonely a smile, we smiled without any style. We kissed altogether wrong, no intentions. We lie about each other's dreams. We live without each other thinking what anyone would do without me and you. It's like I told you, only the lonely can play. So hold on, here we go. Hold on to nothing we know. I feel so lonely way up here. You mentioned the time we were together so long ago. Well, I don't remember. All I know is it makes me feel good now. Only the lonely, only the lonely can play. Hey, hey, Sophia. Only the lonely, only the lonely can play. Come on. Bow, 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 bow. Only the lonely, only the lonely can play. It's like I told you, yeah, lonely can play.
Sophia, what's happening?
Na 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 na. We've been mixing it up. 80s, 70s, standards from the 60s, pop music from the 70s.
We could do a song I really don't know that well. I always have fun with that. Right? Let's see. Let me go over to... To you. Oh, I didn't put the title to this song on the paper. It's going the wrong way. All right, not much. What's happening? You just came back from dropping off your son from his promotion of a wrestling event. Very good, very cool. Congratulations. Totally, that's some good news. I hope everybody's having fun out there. It's a nice Sunday, it's a beautiful Sunday. I've been kicking it here. I don't know if you can see my audience. Well, the Kit Kats, they're back there doing their Zen thing, curled up in little balls. And just relaxing. But they usually like to come into the room when I'm singing. You know what I did at the top of, early on in the first hour? Let me see. We were talking about some history. I got it.
I got a new string put on, so it keeps going out of tune, which is what they do. As y'all know, I'm still learning to play the guitar, and I mess up, but I'm having fun with it. Let's see. I remember a few weeks back, Rudy Moreno, you know, actor, comedian. He said, "Hey, man, I saw your guitar's out of tune." And I told him, I said, "No, it's not. I'm the one that's out of tune." All right. I know without having to repeat conversations, but yeah, we talked about, you know, Hispanic Heritage Month. Even the troubles of just the term Hispanic is strange, you know. Mexican Americans, Hispanics, Chicanos, Chicanas, Chicanx, right? We talked about some of that early on. In my class over at Cal State LA, I facilitated a conversation, and I got to about Merigo Paredes with his pistol in his hand. And part of my discussion with the class was performing this 1901 corrido. Now I'm playing it, I'm strumming it in the only way I know. I'm not full on corrido now, you know what I mean? Like I can't give it that true corrido, but I got a basic strum going. So I'm gonna play it for you. Maybe I should repeat for anybody that's new on here right now. So the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez was written in 1901. Gregorio was a farmer, you know. Him and his brother Ramon had come from Mexico through the lower Rio Grande area between, you know, the state line of Texas and the country Mexico and North America. Because, you know, after 1848, by this time, Mexico had lost the top third to half of its land to United States incursion, invasions, and things like that. But here's Gregorio and his brother in 1901, living in a time where the U.S. Rangers were very violent, murderous, with no accountability against the Mexican population, often accusing them of stealing horses and just being criminal activity. Very similar, sadly, to what we still face today in 2021 in the 21st century is a law that can look at our neighborhoods and communities as hostile territories when the guys with all the guns and all the power are the ones that seem to be fearful of a community that they terrorize. And as I mentioned earlier, Gregorio Cortez, through a loss in translation between Spanish and English, was being accused of making a bad deal with another person on a horse sale or trade. One of the main losses in translation was the question of, did you recently sell a horse? And Gregorio Cortez said no, because they had sold a mare. And the word caballo for horse is different than the word for mare in Spanish. So translations that are lost like that cost lives. And unfortunately, the translator was not a good translator that came along with the sheriff. And the sheriff, as a ranger, they had that habit of shooting first and asking questions later. And so when they went there with this conversation about a horse situation, unfortunately, because of the miscalculation of words, the sheriff did what they typically do. He pulled his gun out. He shot Gregorio Cortez's brother in the mouth. And as he stumbled forward, Gregorio Cortez's brother tried to tackle the sheriff, but he stumbles to the ground. And in that little rough up, the sheriff also took aim at Gregorio. He shot about 2 to 3 times, maybe 4, but I want to say 2 to 3 shots, and he missed every single shot. Not one hit Gregorio Cortez. Gregorio then has his gun already ready, and he doesn't miss and shoots the sheriff 3 times. He lets the translator run off. Gregorio is not a murderer. He was defending himself against an injustice, but unfortunately, in the place he was at, you know, he had to flee. He had to run for his life. He was trying to make it to the Mexico border, but many things happen in a matter of like 10 days where it's sometimes up to 300 Rangers trying to capture Gregorio Cortez. Eventually, he doesn't surrender, but he just, you know, he gets tired. Some of the folklore talks about that he had heard that his wife and family were now in jail. And other parts of the folklore are that, you know, because people were being hanged and terrorized, that he was going to turn himself in. Eventually, you know, Gregorio was sentenced, but he gets a governor's pardon. He's innocent of this idea of being a horse thief. But folklore is funny in that way. The Anglo community always saw him as a horse thief, and the Mexican community always saw him as a hero and defending himself against the injustice of what was happening to Mexicans along the border. I'm going to sing for you the ballad of Gregorio Cortez. There's so much more to say. I feel like I'm doing my conversation again. But if you have questions about Gregorio, ask me. I'll pull the book out. I'll get my notes. They're just right there. And we can talk about it. In the country, in the country of El Carmen, a great misfortune befell. The sheriff is dead. Who killed him, no one can tell. At 2 in the afternoon, in half an hour or less, they knew the man that killed him had been Gregorio Cortez. They let loose the bloodhounds. They followed him from afar, but trying to catch Cortez like following a star. All the rangers in the country were flying. They rode so hard. What they wanted was to get the $1,000 reward. In the country of Kansas, they cornered him after all. Though they were more than 300, he leaped out of their corral. Then the major sheriff said, if he was gonna cry, Cortez, hand over your weapons, we want to take you alive. Then said Gregorio Cortez, and his voice was like a bell, you will never get my weapons till you put me in a cell. Then said Gregorio Cortez, with his pistol in his hand, ah, so many mounted rangers just to take one Mexican. Well, there it is. Cortez, with his pistol in his hand, ah, so many mounted rangers just to take one Mexican. Ah, I like playing with that. Okay. Let me put that guitar down.
Oh, you know, yesterday I was doing a cool little, let me see. Last night, that melody came to me. You know, I got the basic A through F chords, you know, and playing with this guitar. And, wow, we've been going for about an hour and a half now, hour and 32 minutes.
Yeah.
I don't know everybody that's on the stream. I can't see everybody, but thank you for joining me. And Sofia Mendoza and Sofia Marie Mendoza. Wait, maybe it's the same person, right? Two different profiles. Three changes. They're basic. They're cool, though. Rock and roll, you know? It's like basic rock. Acoustic rock. Pop rock. Okay. That was fun playing around with the Ballad of Gregorio Cortez again. But yeah, Hispanic Heritage Month. Trippy, right? Hispanic. What are you, Mexican-American? Chicana, Chicano. Chicanx. Latinx, Hispanic. Some people dig Hispanic. I've never really called myself a Hispanic. always, for me, it was Mexican-American early on. That was my first thing. You come into the world, I'm just a kid crawling around, playing with bugs, having fun. And then at some point I was like, oh, I'm American, right? You get a sense of it from the TV and everything, the radio. And then you're like, oh, what am I? I asked my mom, well, we're Mexican and American. And I was like, what? Kind of like, oh, wow. And yes, we're American because we're here, but we have Mexican heritage. I remember her explaining it in some terms that I could understand. And then my older cousins, because my dad had 9 brothers and 5 sisters from East LA. So I had a lot of older cousins whenever we come to visit familia. And the older cousins would always say, hey, what are you? What are you? I mean, they knew what they were asking. And I would say, I'm Mexican American. And they'd say, no, you're not. You're Chicano. You know, and they'd be like telling me. And I'd be like, oh, all right. I'm Chicano. But, as a kid, you don't understand the historical connotation or the political connotation. You just know that East LA is your family, oldies but goodies, the food we eat and the way we live together, and that's Chicano. So I just looked at it as like, oh, okay, so this is Chicano, but East LA, Mexican-American style, you know? So it wasn't until many, many years later that I, I shouldn't say many, many. I would say by the late teens, my early 20s as a young adult, then I got a better sense of what it means to be a Chicano in the larger society, dominant society, how we're treated as people seen as not fully American, if you know what I'm saying. We were, I guess you could say, stereotyped and, you know, in North Orange County and La Habra, and things of like walking through department stores and security asking us to open our jackets, you know, because they're basically accusing us of shoplifting, which, you know, we weren't stealing anything. But that's the first time that I would tell people. I've shared it in some essays that I've written that I didn't understand then, but that's the first time that the dominant society profiled me as a young kid. I was 12 or 13. And I thought, wow, that's the day I became Chicano. Like systemically, I was like, wow, I'm looked at as a criminal. Like I would do that. And there was no reason. I mean, I was just walking through to go to the arcade, but the security guard took it upon himself to ask me to open my jacket and my brother, but not our friend, who is not Mexican American, if you catch my drift. So I said to myself, thinking back then, so society picks your identity. There's two different things happening. People choose an identity, but then there's another thing of how society sees you, how they perceive you. And that's what complicates things out in the world. How do people see you, right? Latinx, yeah, we spoke about it in the first hour a little bit. And the one thing I will say is that, and I mentioned that Dolores Huerta had mentioned the other day that, you know, because of Hispanic Heritage Month, that she didn't enjoy, she didn't agree with the term Hispanic and Latinx. So she lumped them together. The one thing I will say for anybody that identifies as Latinx or Chicanx, I believe for the younger generation that is doing it because they're looking for some kind of gender neutrality in their identification, I think that's cool. And I think that's good for them. And I don't agree with the usage of the term, how it canvases everything and how people actually take the term and plug it into historical events, which I mentioned before. Like some people might say the Chicanx movement when they're talking about the Chicano movement of the late 60s and 70s. So that's stuff I don't agree with at all. I think it's historically, I believe it's historically wrong because the people at large didn't identify themselves as Chicanx back then. When you get into discussions of gender and sexuality, this is not to say that people that were gender fluid
gay or lesbian, queer. It's not to say they didn't exist, because they did. You know, variations of lifestyle have always existed. So this is not to deny them or to erase them, but this is to talk about history accurately of how the people at large identified themselves. The funny thing is by what I also see by the term using the X, it's doing a reversal of what a lot of marginalized groups have fought against, meaning the erasure of their identity throughout history. So the X, it works in some context for some people, and it's a good thing for their narrative, but at large, it actually starts to erase everybody else. And that's what is very problematic. So it's a complicated conversation, because there are people in the world that want to identify as what is termed in the school system cisgender, meaning a man that identifies as heterosexual masculine and a woman that identifies as heterosexual feminine, and everybody, you know, all these variations. So very interesting conversation about the idea of Latinx, Chicanx. I support people that identify, and if for me, I'm trying to find a time frame, so I keep going to the year 2010 to say this is when that movement began of identity. Like 2010 and afterwards, you have a Chicanx, Latinx movement and why people are identifying as that. But I just don't agree with the anachronistic movida, where they take the term and plug it in everywhere now across the board and back in history. I just don't agree. I find it weird to erase others now. It's like we're trying to all recognize each other, not duplicate Western European history that has historically erased all of us. Chicana feminists have always had that strong argument just against gender ideas of men historians erasing their history. So there's this big decades of work going into non-erasure, and Latinx has elements of erasure, which is ironic. Anyhow, so you know what I'm going to do? That was a nice little run of conversation again. We're going on an hour, 42 minutes, and I said I wasn't going to do that, but I'm going to just do one more song. Let me just catch on some of the thread here. Right. Okay. So I would say, Sophia, yeah, like you're saying you don't agree. And so that's what I'm saying. For me, there's parts of it I don't agree with, and there's parts of it I do agree with. But they're very huge issues of how the term is being used. I wish again that the term would be used for the people who identify as Chicanx, Latinx, but not be used as this overarching descriptor for the entire community, and to use it back in history. That to me just, it erases so much of other people. And it's just the big irony of the usage of the word. So part of it I agree with, and parts of it I don't. It's an interesting conversation. You just learned about it during COVID with public health. Still can't grasp it because it sounds like the eraser of Mexican history. Yeah, there's elements that do that. So it is a complicated conversation. I think I touched on a lot of really important issues. I don't know if we can erase and go back, or erase, if we can rewind and go back and check out some of it. But history doesn't lie, especially if we live through it. But yeah, I'm going to do one more song. I got to get back to work, actually. Even though it's Sunday, I got homework. I'm going to close out with
with eyes without a face. Since we're talking about identity, I'm going to go out with some Billy Idol. And I hope everybody's been enjoying their time. Like the live stream that you're on, please click like. Share with your friends my Venmo, Cash App, and PayPal. As I mentioned before, come on over to Haps. Make a free profile. Get the app. Sponsor me. Support me if you enjoy what I do as an independent artist. As well, my album is streaming everywhere. Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, on the social media platforms, Snapchat, TikTok, Instagram. Play with my music, download it, stream it. All these things help me as an independent artist. So I ask you, I'm looking for my soul family to support me with what I do with my music. But want to say once again, much love and thank you everybody for joining me. I'm going to do one more tune. We're going to do the Billy Idol. Speaking of identity, Eyes Without a Face, 1983, from the Rebel Yell album. Rebel Yell. Little Billy Idol. I'm all out of hope. One more breath, rain could bring a fall. When I'm far from home, don't call me on the phone to tell me you're alone. It's easy to deceive. So your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Got no human grace. Your eyes without a face. Hey, I did Cool Night Again, Angel. Early on, first hour. It's more Paul Davis. But that's okay. This is my last song, though. I spend so much time believing all the lies to keep the dream alive. Now it makes me sad. Makes me mad at you for loving what was you. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Got no human grace. Your eyes without a face, face. When you hear the music, you make a dip into someone else's pocket, then you make a slip. Steal a car, go to Las Vegas. Ooh, the gigolo pool, hanging out by the state line. Turning holy water into wine. Drinking it down. Whoa. I'm on a bus on a psychedelic trip, reading murder books, trying to stay hip. I'm thinking of you, you're so out there. So say your prayers. Say your prayers. Say your prayers. Yeah, Angel, so sorry. We're going on an hour and 49 minutes. I gotta get back to some homework, you know what I'm saying? Oh, but one time, Mr. Billy Idol, we're going out with Eyes Without a Face. Whoa, yeah. Close my eyes and I wonder why.
don't despise. Now all I can do, love what once was so alive in you, but it's gone from your eyes. I better realize. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Got no human grace. Your eyes without a face. Got no human grace. Your eyes without a face, 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 face. Such a human waste. And now it's getting worse. There it is.
I was almost going to let it go again, but you know what? No, I better not. Well, everybody, there it is, hour 49, hour 51 minutes, actually. We did a lot of talking, a lot of chatting, a lot of history, a couple times with that Ballad of Gregorio Cortez. It was really fun to do. I'm going to keep it in the lineup. As a matter of fact, I started looking at some of my political songs and how I can put them into these, I guess you could say, 7-8 syllable line, you know, 4-line phrases. And I started looking at Black Love, Brown Pride. And I could, if I drop a word here and there or a couple words, I can fit it into that corrido syllable breakdown. And I'll keep messing around with the, you know, of course, the guitar. But that's it, everybody. Thank you for joining me. And I'll be back next Sunday. And by the way, drop in some ideas of what days and times you think are good for everybody to hear me sing. I'm still, of course, always open to changing times around and figuring things out. You know, and I'll just work with whatever works best with my schedule too. But that's it, everybody. I want to say much love. Thank you for joining me. You got all my info out there. Please share it. Share it and join me on Habs. Become a sponsor. This is my little telethon. All right. Have a good rest of your Sunday. Much love to you all. Bye-bye, everybody. Until next time.